Following the arrest of 10 pro-democracy figures in Hong Kong, Taiwan civic groups have launched a petition appealing for Hong Kong police to release them and honor their right to free speech.
Monday's police roundup included some of the highest profile leaders of Hong Kong's democracy movement. They were arrested under the city's new national security law, by which they could be extradited to China to stand trial.
Wearing glasses and a face mask and carrying a bundle of clothes, this is Agnes Chow of the now disbanded pro-democracy political party Democisto. She was arrested at her residence at 8 p.m. on Monday. More than 10 police officers were present at the scene. They apprehended Chow and searched her home before taking her away.
And under the strong sense of fear of the national security law, it is even more important for us Hong Kongers to not surrender and to continue to believe in the universal values of democracy and freedom.
Chow was arrested under China's new national security law on accusations of inciting secession. Her arrest was part of a larger operation on August 10th that lasted from 7 a.m. to 10 p.m., in which police raided several locations and arrested 10 people. Among those arrested were Apple Daily founder Jimmy Lai, his two sons, several Apple Daily executives, and pro-democracy activists. That same day, Taiwan's presidential office issued a statement condemning the arrests. On Tuesday, Taiwan activists launched an online petition calling on the Hong Kong government to release the arrestees.
We're afraid the national security law will endanger freedom of speech and civil society. It's saying that for Hong Kong, the days of free speech are numbered. The people who were arrested under the national security law yesterday, including the people from Apple Daily, Agnes Chow, and other civil rights activists, must be released immediately. This is no longer about freedom of the press. This is about law and morality. 200 police officers raided the building. Was that necessary? The oppression over the past year has grown stronger and stronger. The people of Hong Kong are not on retreat.
U.S. Vice President Mike Pence sent out two tweets in response to the arrests. One of them shared a photo of his meeting with the Apple Daily founder last July. He said Lai's arrest was deeply offensive and an affront to freedom-loving people around the world. Meanwhile, U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo also took to Twitter, saying Lai's arrest was further proof that the CCP has eviscerated Hong Kong's freedoms and eroded the rights of its people. Through a spokesperson, UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson said the national security law was being used as a pretext to silence opposition.
First of all, I must stress, the Hong Kong police force always respect the press freedom and the media's right of reporting.
The Hong Kong arrests are believed to be a response to U.S. sanctions on 11 Chinese officials and their allies last Friday. The Apple Daily founder and other arrestees could be sent to China to stand trial. Hong Kong police have denied any connection between their arrests and U.S. sanctions. Whatever the story behind the arrests, fear and silence are taking hold of Hong Kong as the sword of Damocles hangs over its pro-democracy leaders.